Do you want to hear a story? Do you? It is Halloween. And I don't like Halloween. I don't. But it wasn't always so. When I was young, I was a hardcore Halloweener. Don't. But yes, I was. And so, this is a story from October 31st, 1969. Do you want to hear it? Do you? So, it's a story about 6 teenagers, seniors in high school, too old now to dress in the costumes and knock on the doors and get the candy. Too old for that, but it's Halloween. Small town in the middle of the desert, bored seniors in high school. So what do we do? What can we do on Halloween? Indeed, what? Well, let's get my father's station wagon, which holds 9. So we have 3 males in the front, 3 females in the back. And let's drive way out into the empty Mojave D. Far from town, where the town can no longer be seen. Where no man-made lights can be seen. Where the only light that can be seen is from the stars in the galaxy that covers the earth in darkness on October 31st at night. Way out into the desert. Where probably no human has set foot, at least not for hundreds of years. And even then, possibly no human has set foot on that land. Drive out, get off the main road to a dirt road, and off the dirt road, past old abandoned mines and old abandoned shacks that the miners lived in that are rotted wood and a few chimneys remain. Past all of that, out into the nothing. Would you get in the car? Would you? Would you get in the car? Now there's a twist, you see. The goal is for everyone to tell a scary story. You see, we want to scare ourselves. And there are many stories, old-time urban legends, and old stories that people knew back then. People told these stories. But you also have to take your turn outside of the car. Yes. One by one. To exit the car, the station wagon, and disappear from sight into the desert. So no one in the car can see you. And you have to come up with a plan to come back to the car and scare everyone. Would you take your turn outside of the car? Would you? Would you step out alone into the cold October night in the middle of the desert where there is no sign of humans, human life, human existence? Stay out there alone. And come up with a plan to come back to the car and scare everybody. Oh, there's the there were the ones who would come back and you'd feel a bump on the car. Now, the five left in the car are telling scary stories. We're scaring each other. Ooh, ooh. Did you feel that? Did something bump up against the car? What was that? I hear scratching. What's that? And then all of a sudden, somebody would jump up. Whoever was out there would jump up into the window, right? Something like that. That was something to do. There were other more inventive things to do. But would you do it? Would you get in the car and drive out there? Away from all adults, away from all authority. Would you get out of the car? Would you take your turn outside? Now, Tom has been gone for 30 minutes. He went out and disappeared like he's supposed to. And we don't realize it's been 30 minutes because we're entertaining ourselves. Until someone says, "Where's Tom?" I don't know about the others, but I'd completely forgotten that he even got out of the car. Can't be 30 minutes. Usually, I mean, whoever goes out is. Comes back and scares us within 5 minutes. Turn on the dash lights to see the clock. Tick, yeah. It's been 30 minutes. Looking, straining your eyes, 10 eyeballs, straining, looking, into the desert as far as we can see anyway, which isn't far. It's dark. It's country dark. So dark, I can't see the faces of the girls in the back seat. I can see the shadows of their heads, but I can't see their faces. It's dark. Straining our ears, 10 ears straining to hear something. Roll down your window. No! Roll your window down so we can hear. Roll your window down. I'm not going to roll down my window. Roll down your window. He went out on your side. The wind is blowing this way. Opening my window won't help. We need to hear from that side. Open your window. No, I'm not going to open the window. I'm not going to. No. You have to go out. You have to go out and find him. Yeah. The two of you need to go out. You're big and strong. Fast. Yeah. And you aren't. You three girls are not big and strong. The two of us need to go out and find Tom. But you know, if we don't come back, you're going to have to get in the front seat. Start the car. Turn on the lights, the headlights. Put it in reverse. Back out of here. Turn it around. And find the road. You'll have to stay away from the soft sand because the car will get stuck. Can you do that? No sign of Tom. If you get the car stuck in the soft sand, what will you do out here alone? Well, Tom's alone. Tom's out there alone. He might be hurt. Yeah, I know. What would you do? Would you have even gotten in the car to begin with? Would you have taken your turn outside of the car, alone in the desert? Shall I tell you what happened to Tom? Do you want to hear it? Do you want to know? Do you? Well, you know I'm here. So you know I'm here. What you don't know is where the other five are. You don't know their whereabouts. You don't know if October 31st, 1969 was the last they were ever seen.